America's aviation industry slowly resuming operations after a system outage similar to what happened here in the Philippines triggered delays and flight cancellations across the U.S. ABS-CBN North America Bureau Chief TJ Manotoc now joins us with an update. TJ, how are things there?
Carmina, just a few weeks after one of the worst winter storms in history caused massive flight cancellations that ruined millions of people's holiday plans, Americans today woke up to what seemed like deja vu as flights were grounded across the country in what officials are saying was a technical glitch. More than 1,200 flights were canceled and more than 9,000 delayed because of a Federal Aviation Administration system outage early Wednesday morning. The countrywide grounding was lifted at around 9 a.m. Eastern time and gradually flights were able to take off. But throughout the day, airlines were warning passengers of continued delays due to congestion and a domino effect of the delays and cancellations. Most major airlines, namely Southwest Airlines, United, Delta, and American Airlines, all reported 40% or more of flight disruptions. Here in the Bay Area, it did not seem to have much of an impact on the West Coast, as only about 20 flights got canceled and 83 were delayed in SFO. Officials saying it was right around the average and it was hard to say if it was due to the nationwide FAA grounding. Aviation authorities have said what caused the stoppage was an outage to a system the FAA uses to send real-time safety alerts to pilots called the NOTAM, or Notice to Air Mission Alerts, which are crucial to planning flights and used to share information about hazards in the air or on the ground. At around 3:30 p.m. Pacific time, the FAA released an update that the outage in the NOTAM was due to a damaged database file and reiterated it was not due to a cyber attack. Earlier in the day, U.S. Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg was quick to say it was not caused by a cyber attack, but says it is a clear signal that improvements need to be made.
This gives us a really important data point and a really important moment to understand what we're going to need moving forward. But obviously, our more immediate focus is technical, understanding exactly how this happened, why the redundancies and the backups that were built into the system were not able to prevent the level of disruption that we saw today, and to make sure that we have 100% clarity on any and all steps that are needed so that it can't happen again. The FAA system so far has made it possible for an extraordinary safety record to be built up in the United States. But that system also constantly needs to be tended to, upgraded, refreshed, and there are a number of processes underway right now in the FAA to make sure that those systems stay up to date.
Casey, as much as this is a bad thing to cause delays and disruptions, the good thing is apparently Wednesday is the slowest day of travel here in the U.S., and this will spur the aviation authorities to further enhance their capabilities for backups, redundancies, and innovations needed. Carmina?
Thanks a lot, our North America Bureau Chief there, TJ Manotoc, joining us live. Thanks again, Teej. And back here in the newsroom, U.S. President Joe Biden's aides have reportedly discovered a second batch of classified documents in a new location. The documents are from Biden's time as vice president. According to NBC News, the classification level and precise location of this batch of documents were not immediately clear. The first batch was discovered in Biden's former private office in Washington. The president has said he is unaware of the contents of the files, but vowed full cooperation with the investigation. Several Republican lawmakers have called for a damage assessment on the discovery of the classified documents. A new Russian general will oversee the country's military campaign in Ukraine. That responsibility now falls on the chief of the general staff, Valery Gerasimov. This is the latest shakeup in Moscow's military leadership as Russia continues to face stiff resistance in Ukraine. Russia's defense ministry says the change is meant to make their military campaign more effective. But pro-war critics are unimpressed. The military has faced criticisms after dozens of Russian soldiers were killed in a Ukrainian strike on New Year's Day.